Hi, welcome back to our App Inventor tutorial. So today is our special lesson on Emulator. So remember last time we just start our lesson one and we didn't try things out yet. So in order to try our apps, App Inventor actually provide three ways for us to try. So if you have an Android phone, you can just connect your phone to your computer with a USB cable, or we here we have AI Companion where the QR code can you can directly download your apps through this QR code. So what if we don't have an Android phone, and that's why we need Emulator? So Emulator actually is a kind of simulator to an Android phone that runs on our computer. So before running the emulator, we can go to App Inventor tool. So make sure you check this link and install the App Inventor tool in your computer. So after you install it, just run the AI starter. And here is just some commands, system commands that I don't really need to care about this. So we run our emulator. It usually takes some time because, you know, it's free, right? So we don't have Android phone, we use our computer, and if your computer is like super slow, it can take like a minute or two. So okay, here is our emulator, our Android phone. So we need to wait, and you have to be very patient. Oh. Yeah, and App Inventor website actually have a lot of protection, so it have to make sure that your app, your emulator actually is working. So it has a little countdown to make sure that everything is running fine. So even if we have our emulator, we have to start the companion. So what the companion does is to connect our apps we just created to your Android device. Okay. So it seems like our companion app is out of date, so have to make an update, right? So just click OK. Well, here's very important notice from the App Inventor, so make sure you read all these things. Click OK to update our data and install. Okay, make sure do not click open, just click done. And we wait a little bit. Okay. Well, actually, the emulator is not very efficient, in my opinion, because it's super slow. So you can check our version just got updated to 2.39, and it should be what we have on the App Inventor website. Here, see the 2.39 version. So we have to wait to get the blocks. Remember logic blocks we just discussed in lesson one. So if your project is a very large scale one, it might take like 5 minutes to 10 minutes to load all every blocks. Is something wrong with the emulator? I'm not sure, because it's just super slow. Maybe we can restart our connection, I guess. Okay, it finally works. It takes some time, but here's our apps from our lesson one. So you can see we have the test button. Here we can click our button and it reacts. Here's the checkbox. So a little bit difference about the graphics, right? And also our logo, you can see the image, the size is sorry, the size is different. And our task is like in the middle of the screen, but here in our viewer is kind of in the bottom. So when deciding our apps, so make sure that you really have a an emulator or an Android phone to try things out, because you never know from just the viewer. So that's pretty much about this lesson. A brief introduction on how to get the emulator works. So see you in next lesson, and in next lesson we are going to make a little apps where we can try buttons, logic blocks, and some blocks to control the image. So see you next time.